So what happened to the real estate market for March 2020? Well, that's what I'm talking about today, and I'm starting right now. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Angela O'Hare, your local Las Vegas realtor, and welcome to my monthly market update for Southern Nevada. And today, I'm going to be talking about March 2020 numbers. Well, believe it or not, even with everything going on with the coronavirus, the Las Vegas real estate market hit an all-time high for the month of March, which is pretty crazy. I think that we're really not going to see the true numbers of the real estate market until maybe next month or even June, because even though March was another banner month, you got to take into consideration people put these offers in February. So this is not going to be an accurate depiction of how the real estate market really is going to land. I mean, obviously no one knows what's going to happen with the market. We don't know if it's going to crash. We don't know if the sellers are going to lower the prices, if buyers can get great deals. We don't know. Everything's up in the air, and that's just the way it is right now with the entire world. I have a feeling that if you are able to buy and want to buy, then I would wait another month or two just to see how everything plays out. In my opinion, I would just wait and hold off another month or two just to see what's going on with the market. So I'm just going to go over the numbers and take it with a grain of salt of how last month's numbers were, just because, again, it's not a true depiction of really what's going to be happening in the next few months with our market. So March, there were 2,758 single family houses that sold, which is up 11.6% from February and up 5.2% from March 2019. And then the median sales price of previously owned single family homes, again, reached another all-time high to $319,000, up 0.9% from February and up 6.3% from the prior year, according to the Las Vegas Realtors, which was formerly known as the Greater Las Vegas Association of Realtors. Could you imagine without the coronavirus happening, what the Las Vegas real estate market would look like? I mean, it was getting crazy. And I know it's sad to say, and I hate saying this, but I'm thankful that there's going to be a market correction. 2020 was going to be, I have a feeling it was going to be a very banner year. Just by looking at the numbers from January through March, everything was just going up, 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 up. And I'm thankful, not thankful that people are dying due to this virus, but I'm thankful that we are having a market correction and that we will be able to stabilize it and make homes more affordable for people. Yeah, I'm a real estate agent, and yeah, it's nice to have the homes higher, but I don't look at it as that way. I look at it as what is affordable for everyone involved, and I feel everyone should be able to afford a home and live in it comfortably. So they say that the tally of canceled deals nearly doubled last month. So could you imagine if some of these deals went through, how high those numbers would actually be? It's kind of scary. And Southern Nevada had a total number of 3,605 new listings for the month of March, up 11.3% from February, but down 18.2% from the prior year. There were also a total number of 5,687 single family houses listed without offers at the end of March, up 34.1% from February and down 19.8% from the prior year. And it makes sense why the listings were down for last month, because come mid-March, that was when the whole everything was declared epidemic, pandemic, whatever you want to call it. It makes sense that why we didn't have as many listings. And plus, who wants to have people come in through your home? I mean, the one big thing that people are doing now is virtual tours, but there's nothing like actually taking a physical tour of a home. I could not buy a home by just doing a virtual tour, because you need to have the feeling of the home, the feeling of the neighborhood, the community. It's not the same. Again, if I were a buyer and if I were a seller, now's not the time to be listing your home and now's not the time to be buying. Unfortunately, sad to say, even though I could use the money, it's just really, really just not the time at all to do any of it, unfortunately. If I were you, let's play everything out. Let's see how this coronavirus plays out and how it affects the market. And now there's about a 2.1 months of housing supply in Southern Nevada, which is up 20.2% from February, but down 23.8% from the prior year. Last month, I think it was at 1.7. Again, if we continue to go the rate that we were, we would have just been crazy, crazy. Multiple offers, bidding wars, all that jazz. And I'm thankful that we're not going to be in that trend right now, because 2018 was very similar to 2020 and it was not fun. It was not fun working with buyers that were put into a multiple offer situation, or even with sellers that had 20 to 30 different offers to choose from. It's just not a fun situation to be in on both ends of the parties or both sides of the deal. And 59% of the closings for the month of March was on the market 30 days or less. In February, this number was at 50.4%. And in March 2019, it was 51.9% of the homes were on the market for 30 days or less. There were still about a total of 2,492 homes that were canceled in the month of March, which is up 94% from the prior year. So could you imagine if those sales went through? Then it would have been just a super banner month. We had what, a total number of 2,700 single family homes sold on top of the 2,500 homes that were canceled. That's like almost what, over 5,000 homes that would have sold for the month of March, if you think about it and put it in those terms. That's all I have for now. In reality, March numbers is not a true depiction of how the numbers are going to proceed. We still have this month, April, to go over, and I'm sure there were some deals at the beginning of March that are going to be closing in April, which I have a deal closing at the end of this month. But I think June's numbers, or when I go over June's numbers for May, will be a true depiction of how the Las Vegas market is going to, or how the Las Vegas market is going to get hit because of the coronavirus and no one buying and everyone losing their jobs and all that jazz, okay? So stay tuned for next month when I go over April's numbers. And the most important thing is gonna be May's numbers when I go over how hard the market got hit. And it's gonna take us a while, months, maybe a year to recuperate from this. Hopefully it's not gonna be as bad as 2008 recession, but you just never know how things are gonna play out. If you would like to download the full report provided by the Las Vegas Realtors, I've posted a link down in the description below. And as always, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, share with a friend, subscribe, you know, because I don't just talk about real estate. Well, I do a lot, but I do talk about Las Vegas in general. And I also go over a lot of the neighborhoods here in Las Vegas. Be safe. I pray for everyone. Stay home. I know it's very hard for some of you to stay home. Luckily, I'm used to staying home, so I have lots of things to do that doesn't affect me at all. I'm not bored at all. I have lots of videos to make, lots of things to do around my house. Actually, I started doing macrame. I made a macrame plant holder the other day. I made a hemp necklace the other day. So I'm starting a lot of crafts right now just to have fun with it all. But again, I'm not bored just yet, unlike some other people who are, that are used to going to a normal 9-to-5 job or a normal job. But it's like this for a reason, for us to be safe and healthy, and I hope that everyone takes care of themselves. Anyway, thank you so much for watching today, and I will definitely see you guys on the next one.